is my philosophy too. If you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and then make a change.
My childhood was completely taken away from me. There was no Christmas, there was no birthdays. It was not a normal childhood, no normal pleasures of childhood. Those were exchanged for hard work, struggle and pain, and eventual material and professional success. But as an awful price, I cannot recreate that part of my life, nor would I change any part of my life. However, today, when I create my music, I feel like an instrument of nature. I wonder what delight nature must feel when we open our hearts and express our God-given talents. The sound of approval rolls across the universe, and the whole world abounds in magic. Wonder fills our hearts for what we have glimpsed for an instant, the playfulness of life. And that's why I love children and learn so much from being around them. I realize that many of our world's problems today, from the inner city crime to large-scale wars and terrorism and our overcrowded prisons, are a result of the fact that children have had their childhood stolen from them. The magic, the wonder, the mystery, and the innocence of a child's heart are the seeds of creativity that will heal the world. I really believe that.
Michael Jackson is one of the biggest artists of our time. Despite that, he had many hardships. He needed to find his purpose and felt creativity could heal the world. Most of his later music also showed the admiration of children and the simplistic way that they approach problems in our world. This is definitely evident in his song, Man in the Mirror, saying that if you want to make the world a better place, take a look at yourself and then make a change. In spite of failures that may have been in his life, this lasting message remains as a lesson to us all.
One that no person should ever have to suffer. And even after experiencing the indignity of this search, the parties involved were still not satisfied and wanted to take even more pictures. It was a nightmare, horrifying nightmare. But if this is what I have to endure to prove my innocence, my complete innocence, so be it. Throughout my life, I have only tried to help thousands upon thousands of children to live happy lives. It brings tears to my eyes when I see any child who suffers. I am not guilty of these allegations, but if I am guilty of anything, it is of giving all that I have to give to help children all over the world. It is of loving children of all ages and races. It is of gaining sheer joy from seeing children with their innocent and smiling faces. It is of enjoying through them the childhood that I missed myself. If I am guilty of anything, suffer little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. I am totally innocent of any wrongdoing, and I know these terrible allegations will all be proven false. For decades, the NAACP has stood at the forefront of the struggle for equal justice under the law for all people in our land. They have fought in the lunchrooms of the South, in the hallowed halls of the Supreme Court, and in the boardrooms of corporate America for justice, equality, and the very dignity of all mankind. Members of the NAACP have been jailed and even killed in the noble pursuit of those ideals upon which our country was founded. None of these goals is more meaningful for me at this time in my life than the notion that everyone is presumed to be innocent. I never really took the time to understand the importance of that ideal until now, until I became the victim of false allegations.
My purpose? Oh boy, I think to give in the best way I can, through song, through dance, and through music. I mean, I am committed to my art. I believe that all art has as its ultimate goal the union between the material and the spiritual, the human and the divine. I believe that to be the reason for the very existence of art. I feel I was chosen as an instrument to just give music and love and harmony to the world.
I think with any type of creation, you create what's inside of you. Subconsciously, what influences you? I'm a fantasy fanatic, and anything that takes you off into another world, escapism, that's what I like. I'm not so crazy about the reality of everything. I like a lot of fantasy, and that's what I try to create. To get away, to become moved, to become moved.
Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed our content, please don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe to our channel.